Hi guys, so let's make some mead. But before we do that, let's talk a little about the ingredients. You might know that mead consists of water, honey and yeast, but there is a fourth ingredient that often is overlooked, especially amongst English-speaking mead makers. And that ingredient is meadowsweet. Meadowsweet is recognized as something one might use to make mead. But I propose that it's not optional, it's necessary to make Viking Age mead. And here's why. In Scandinavia, the land of the Vikings, the name of meadowsweet is Mjødurt. And Mjødurt translates into mead herb. And that to me is a strong indication that if you want to make Viking Age mead, you need meadowsweet. But it would be nice to find something that firmly could establish the connection between the Vikings and meadowsweet. And this is it. I'm standing on a large Viking Age burial mound. It is surrounded by meadowsweet. And if we look over there to the next burial mound, it is also surrounded by meadowsweet. I think it's safe to say that meadowsweet was very important to the Vikings. So let's go and make some Viking mead with meadowsweet. So we need some meadowsweet, and this is what it looks like. So you can buy some online or you can harvest it yourself. What we want is the flowers, and those can be harvested from late June till early August, depending on where you live. My goal here is to make this mead as authentic as possible. And that means no chemicals and no commercial yeast. I will instead rely on Odin to provide me with yeast, and he can do so in different ways. I am using raw Norwegian honey, straight from the beehive, nothing is done to it, and that might contain yeast. Yeast is also in the air that surrounds us, so as we'll see in a moment, I will leave the honey water outside overnight in order to catch some from the air. And finally, the meadowsweet that we are going to use should also contain yeast. So, cover it with a mosquito net and leave it outside overnight. The next day, put a good handful of meadowsweet in an airtight container. And add the honey water. Seal it up and wait for the fermentation to begin. Give it a stir once a day to keep the meadowsweet moist. That will prevent mold from forming. When the fermentation is well underway, it is time to pour the brew into a carboy. And then we wait for the fermentation to finish, while we look forward to some sweet Viking mead. It should take about 5 or 6 weeks. And that's it. A quick and easy way to make mead. And if you use wild yeast and meadowsweet, you'll get a Viking mead that is as authentic as possible. And here it is. When using wild yeast, you never know what you're gonna get. So let's open it, have a taste,
and see what we got. It looks nice. Very nice color. Clear, beautiful. Oh yes, oh yes. Odin has been kind to me once again, because this is good mead. Very good. Oh, it's nice. So I can choose to drink it now. It is actually drinkable straight away. It's that good. Or I can choose to store it for some months to let the taste mellow out even more. You'll find the recipe below. I've also included a link to another YouTube channel called Man-Made Mead, in case you want to learn more about mead making. So thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.